Hello friends, today I am going to explain you a movie Fool's Gold. At the beginning of the story, Finn is shown with his friend at the bottom of the sea. Finn and his friend are trying to find a ship named Orelia. That ship was lost in 1715. That ship was full of treasures. Finn was searching for that ship for the last 8 years. Finn was searching for that ship's evidence using a machine. That machine was running with the help of a generator that was in his boat. The generator created a spark, and due to that spark, paper caught fire. That paper flew into their room and the whole boat caught fire. The boat explodes and it sinks and hits the bottom of the sea. Due to this, the sea mud starts to float, and during that, Finn got something in his hand. That was a piece of plate which was from 1715. That plate was given as a gift to Queen at her wedding. He was very happy after getting that piece of plate. Finn and his friend came to the surface and didn't see their boat. Those fools didn't know that the thing that fell to the bottom of the sea and made that piece of plate come out of its place was their boat. Now, they both know that their boat has sunk into the sea. At that time, two men arrived there. They took Finn and his friend to their boss, which was on another ship. He is a gangster. He gave lots of money to Finn, and now he wants his money back. Finn doesn't have any money left with him. He only had one boat that also sank. Finn showed him that piece of plate and told him that plate was in that ship that was carrying treasure. Many years ago, that ship sank there, and now I know that ship is somewhere around that area. Finn said, I can find that ship, but I need your help. Finn showed that plate to the gangster, but he thought that was normal crockery. That's why he didn't believe Finn. That gangster told his men to throw Finn into the water. Those men tied heavy metals into Finn's leg and tried to throw him into the sea, but Finn tries to stop them. During that, Finn takes one man's gun. Those men threw Finn into the water, but he catches the ship, and while they came to push him, he shoots them. After that, he fell into the sea. He was tied with heavy metal. That's why he reached the bottom of the sea. When he looked around, he saw his gun at some distance. He jumped like a frog to get to that gun. He breaks his lock and he came to the surface. Today he has to visit the court also, because today he has a divorce case with his wife. In court, his wife Tess and judge are waiting for him. They were waiting for him for a long time, but he didn't arrive. Now judge told her that if Finn didn't show up in 15 minutes, then all his properties will be yours and she will get divorced too. Finn reaches there late. The judge has already made his decision, which was in Finn's wife's favor. Finn tries to talk to his wife, but she told him that I am done with you. 8 years ago you left me for the treasure. Now I want to leave my life on my way, and I want to complete my studies. Finn asked her, how are you going to pay for her studies? She replied that judge had decided in my favor, and all of your properties are mine. I will sell your boat for my college bills. Finn told her that his boat sank into the sea. Tess gets angry after hearing that, and she hits him with a stick in his head. Now Finn told her that he had found that place where the ship filled with treasures was located. He showed her that plate's logo on paper. Tess gets happy after seeing that logo because she recognizes that logo. She asked him to show her that plate. Finn told her that he doesn't have that plate with him. Tess thought that Finn is lying to her, and she gets upset, and she goes from there. Tess joined her old job, which is in a yacht. Her boss's name is Nigel. Tess wants to earn money anyhow so that she could go to Chicago and complete her studies. She told her boss that we should move from this place because she doesn't want Finn to be there. But her boss Nigel denied going from there. He told her that my daughter is also coming here. She wants to go shopping on nearby islands. Here Finn is shown at the bar with his old friend, with whom he was searching for the treasure. His friend told him that there is a yacht nearby which is owned by a very rich guy. His name is Nigel. He can help you on finding that treasure. Finn asked him, how can I get to him? His friend told him, Nigel's daughter is coming here in a chopper. If you want to get to him, then you have to be friends with his daughter. Then they saw a girl landing from a chopper on a yacht. She was Nigel's daughter. After that, Nigel's daughter starts to move toward the island on a boat. Finn also starts to go towards yacht on his motorboat. At that time, Nigel's daughter's hat flew in the air. Finn tries to save her hat, and he successfully catches her hat. But Nigel's daughter's boat hits Finn's boat, and he fell into the water. But Nigel's daughter saved him and brought him into her boat. Now they took Finn to the yacht where Nigel met Finn for the first time. Nigel's daughter told him that he tried to save my hat. He is a very good guy. Nigel invites him for the dinner. At night, when they were all at their dining table, Tess comes there, and she screamed when she saw Finn there. Here, Nigel came to know that they both know each other. Finn told Nigel that Tess and I were husband and wife, but we are now divorced. Now Tess and Finn both told Nigel about the treasure. They told him that in the year 1715, a group of Spanish ships, which was carrying a king's treasure. Among those ships, there was a ship named Orlaya, which believed that it can pass sea storms, so all the treasures were shifted to that ship. All the ships sank due to the storm. But after 3 years, a man was seen on that island, and he was the captain of Orlaya's ship. He saved that ship, which was carrying all the treasures, and he hid that ship somewhere on that island. And now I've got the clue for that ship. He told them that I've got the piece of a plate of that ship, which means that ship is hidden somewhere around that area. After hearing all these, Nigel and his daughter agree to help him search for that treasure. But the next morning, Finn saw that gangster has bought that island where he had found that piece of plate. Nigel gets angry and told him that he shouldn't have told him about that treasure and plate. Now, how can we get to the treasure? Finn tells them that he has bought the island, but he hasn't bought the sea. When they reach the place where he found that plate, they saw a boat already searching for the treasure, and he was Finn's ex-mentor. He tells Finn that this treasure is mine. Finn also told him that whoever finds the treasure first will keep it. And after that, Finn gets into the water, and he saw that his mentor's people are planting dynamite where he found that piece of plate. After planting the dynamite, they went back to the surface. Finn starts to cut their wires. Finn accidentally cuts the wrong wire, due to which one of the dynamite explodes. And from there, one old royal sword came toward him. Finn gets shocked after seeing that. Finn's mentor saw him in the water. Finn's mentor told his people not to blast dynamites because Finn was still there in the water. But one of his people pressed a button which caused a big blast of dynamite, due to which Finn came flying to his mentor's boat. After that, his mentor beats him badly. The royal sword landed on Nigel's yacht. After that, they sent Finn to Nigel's yacht. At night time, when Finn was in his room, he starts to think of something. And there Tess was also thinking of something. Tess came to Finn's room, but Finn was not there. Finn has reached the bar on the island, which is owned by that gangster. He wanted to ask something about them, but one of the members hits him with the bat, and he gets unconscious there. And when he woke up, he was in front of that gangster. Finn told him that the man you've hired to search for that treasure used to be my mentor. He cannot find the treasure for you. I can help you find that treasure, and I will give you 10% of that treasure. After hearing that, the gangster starts to laugh because he wanted all of that treasure. He told Finn, if you help me find that treasure, I will leave you alive. And after that, he lets Finn go. Finn came back to the yacht where he meets Tess. Tess asked him, how much money have you taken from the gangster? And he replied, I have taken $60,000 from him. And if I didn't return him that money, then he will kill me. The next morning, they again went back to that location and start searching for the treasure. They searched for the whole day, but they didn't get anything. At night time, they all were sitting together. They were thinking about why they haven't found that ship yet. Finn told them that the water in that area is very clean. If the ship was in that location, till now someone would have already found it, which means the ship wasn't in that location. At that time, Nigel's yacht captain came there and told him that a sea storm is about to come. That's why we have to move our yacht to the north beach of the island. After saying that, he goes from there. After hearing that, Finns go near the captain and asked him, why do you want to move our yacht to the north beach? The captain replies, North Beach is the only area on this island where there are no rocks. And Finn understands that Orlaya's ship was hidden there. After that, they went to that place. Finn and Tess start to search for that ship under the water. And after searching for some time, they found the cannon of the Spanish ship. And they understood that Orlaya's ship's captain tried to bring his ship to this location to save his ship, which sank here later. The next morning, they start digging and searching for that ship, and they found lots of parts of that ship, but they didn't get treasures. After that, they think that the ship's captain must have hidden his treasure somewhere on this island. There was a very old church on that island. They think that they can get clues about that treasure in that church. They both reach that church where there were very old books. Tess starts to read a book and there was written, "I am not the first person that came here. Spanish had already came before me. Here was a girl whose name was Orelia and her coffin is still there." After reading that, they both get shocked because Orelia wasn't the name of any girl. It was the name of that ship that was carrying those treasures. After that, they both went to the graveyard where they found the grave of Orelia. And when they dig Orelia's grave, they found a drum that had some notes which were written by that ship's captain. He wrote that, "After searching for a long time, finally, I found a place to hide the treasures, but no one can find those treasures because the place where I have hidden those treasures, it is a death trap where water is filled whole year, and only in December someone can go there once or twice." After hearing that, Finn understood that the treasure is hidden inside the blowhole. Blowhole is a cave which is connected with the sea, which opens from the top, but it is always filled with the water. But before they reach to that place, Gangster and his men came there. He asks for that diary. Finn throws that diary towards them, and after that they starts to fight. Finn and Tess somehow gets out from there on their bike. When they were moving, Tess accidentally fell from the bike, and when Finn looked at her, his bike fell from a hill which caused a huge blast. Tess thought Finn got killed in that accident, and she starts to scream. Here, Gangster and his people came to that place, and they caught Tess. After that, they took Tess near that blowhole because now they also know the location of that treasure. They tied a rope around Tess's waist and they sent her inside the hole. When she got into the hole, she saw that there was a tunnel inside the water. She went into that tunnel and there she found that treasure. There were Spanish cannons too, and she untied her rope and she tied that rope around that cannon. After that, she grabs one of the treasure box because she knew that a huge water pressure is about to come there. When the water pressure came, that treasure box slipped from her hand, due to which the gold coins of that box came out flying through that tunnel. After seeing that, the Gangster and his men were sure about that treasure in that place. After that, Gangster's men goes inside the water for that treasure. Here, Finn is shown and he is still alive. He came to his mentor asking for help to find that treasure. Now, Finn also reached to that place where treasure was hidden. That Gangster saw him and starts to shoot at him. Finn somehow reached to that blowhole, dodging those bullets. He saw Tess inside that blowhole. He jumps inside that blowhole to save Tess. Gangster's men were also there. Now, again, the water pressure was about to come. Tess also tied Finn with her using that rope. But before the water pressure came, one of the Gangster men took one of the treasure box to that Gangster. Gangster asked him, "Where is my another man?" And he replied, "He is still inside the water." At that time, Gangster saw a big water pressure coming outside of that blowhole, and it was red in color. Actually, his man was blown due to the pressure, and he hit the rocks, which leads him to death. After seeing that, Gangster got angry, and he gave a water arrow gun to his man. He told his man to kill them both, and after that, his man starts to swim towards them. Now, Finn's mentor arrives there. He saw a Gangster's member inside the water, which was going to kill Tess and Finn. He jumps into the water, and the Gangster man shoots the water arrow gun to the mentor, and it hits on his leg. After that, they starts to fight. Here, Gangster is shown who is trying to put the treasure box inside the plane, but it slipped from his hand, and the box hits on his man's head, and he dies there. Now, Tess and Finn also arrives at the surface of the water. That Gangster caught Tess and pulled her inside the plane. He starts the plane. Tess tries to attack him, but he made her unconscious. Before the plane took off, Nigel's daughter came there. She has brought a water scooter. She took Finn with her and went near that plane which was about to take off. Finn caught that plane. Gangster saw Finn hanging on the plane. He opens the door and tries to shoot at Finn, but at that time, Tess wakes up and she kicked him out of that plane. Finn quickly gets into that plane and he took control of that plane. Now they both know the location of all of the Spanish treasures, but Finn doesn't know how to land the plane. Their plane got crashed, but they both survived. After that, Finn again proposed Tess for the marriage, which means that they both are into relationship again. At the end of the movie, it is shown that after getting all the treasure, they all were very rich. Tess was pregnant too. All those treasure were kept in a museum where people from different countries came to watch. The story ends here. Thank you for watching our video. Like and subscribe to our channel for more amazing stories like this.